Is Dave Bautista's latest action comedy any good? Let's dive in.
What's up, it's Film Frenzy, and I recently saw the Dave Bautista-led spy comedy, My Spy, which debuts in theaters March 13th, 2020. So let's get right into this review with my first category, Direction and Visuals.
So I think something that's necessary to clarify about My Spy is that even though it is an action comedy, it's way more on the comedy side than action, and really only has a couple core action sequences, way less than like Dave Bautista's film last year, Stuber. This really focuses more on like the family elements of like his interaction with the little girl and her mother and stuff, and so it's more of a comedy, and that means that it's not going to have as much like breathtaking action sequences and like visual stuff. I think the action sequences were very good, actually. The first one was very campy, but kind of leaned into that, and I liked that. And then the finale one was really awesome, and I actually like really enjoyed it. It had some really unique elements, which is really, really cool. That was more, though, in like the story, the plot of the action sequence, than, let's say, the visuals themselves, but they were still very entertaining to watch, and I enjoyed it. I didn't think there was anything downright bad about the film overall with the direction and visuals. There was nothing that really, like, jumped out to me. I was like, oh my gosh, wow. And the shots really, this is not meant to be some gorgeously cinematographied, not a word, but you guys know what I mean, movie, and that's okay. It's good for what it is. I'm giving it still a solid enough 4 out of 5 for direction and visuals. Not bad at all.
Now it's time to discuss acting and character development.
Let's start with the biggest negative, and that's in the villain department. Usually these action comedy films just really don't have a very developed villain, and this is one of the worst cases of that. I mean, he was just so, like, just boring and just, like, had no, like, character, like, multi-layers and stuff. It was just basically about money and very uninteresting. Just like generic villain lines, and that was really unfortunate, especially because one of the most unique elements of this film is the connection between one of like the protagonists, the little 9-year-old girl, and her family connection to the villain, which I thought was really interesting. That's not like a big spoiler, by the way, that's like revealed in the trailer. That's why Dave Bautista is surveilling the little girl and her mother, and I thought that was really interesting, but then they barely played into that, which is so unfortunate, because that would have been such like a great just like opportunity for some really powerful drama. Maybe that's not meant for this film, because this is way more of a comedy, and maybe it ruins the tone, but I thought it was some really interesting stuff that had a lot of potential that was so undercooked, which is unfortunate. But on the other hand, Dave Bautista, even though he's kind of your generic like tough guy character who you see in a lot of movies, him playing some of those, and other characters, you know, just the standard tale of like this like tough guy who lost his heart, but he's like, you know, a cop, or he's a spy, or he's a soldier, or he's multiple ones like he is in this movie, and his relationship with like, you know, a surprising person, whether it's Kumail Nanjiani's Uber driver in Stuber, or if it's this little girl who is 9 years old. And I thought that this connection was actually pretty good, and the chemistry all around was really excellent. Overall, the thing that makes this movie, I think, a very enjoyable film is the acting. All around is top notch, which is great to see. Dave Bautista, yeah, he's being typecast, and this is like all of his other characters, but he plays that perfectly. And though his character isn't super original, it is still very well developed. And the little girl is phenomenal. The actress that plays her is excellent. So is the mom. She is really good. She does just a great job and plays a lot of layers. And when it does get more dramatic, I thought she pulled it off really well, because sometimes drama and comedies can be really difficult to do, and I've seen it done poorly and cringy so many times. So it's great to see her do it well. And even though the villain is pretty weak, the performance was fine. The supporting characters like Christian Shaw and Ken Jeong were great. I actually thought Christian Shaw was really cool, because usually these films, like, they have a very strict formula, and this movie is very predictable, but I think a big, like, not twist, but spin on the thing, is that they had a different character than you usually see in these films, and Christian Shaw, she was, like, a very different type of character than most spy films, and I thought it was very interesting to watch her play out, and she's a great actress, she's really hilarious, but she does drama great too, and it was a very well-developed character, which was, I think was one of the biggest surprises of the film, and it's really great to see her in more movies, because I loved her in Last Man on Earth, and she's really just a phenomenal actress. So, for this category, yeah, it's a bit of a mixed bag, but I'm still giving a super solid 4 out of 5.
And my last topic up for discussion are the story elements of plot, pacing, script, and theme.
Finally, the big kahuna of my three categories, and it's gonna be a little weaker. I mean, usually it is with this type of movie. What do you expect, you know? They weren't trying for something that's like groundbreaking or anything. This isn't 1917, this isn't Parasite, but what they were trying for, I think they mostly achieved. And the plot, like I said, it's insanely predictable. This is the type of film where the two characters learn from each other, and yay, it's fun, we have laughs along the way, you kind of know where the journey's going, just like Stuber, but it's how you get there. And the thing with this movie is, it's a little bit more interesting and less basic than Stuber, but sometimes that can be a good thing, what Stuber did, because this one, sometimes when it veers off course, yeah, it's great, I do love the moments where it gets really strange and weird, but sometimes when they try to do something a little different, they maybe don't, like, explain the spy technology very well, or there's some, like, plot holes, or some awkward plot devices, and, like, just parts of the plot where it just doesn't, like, really match up very well, and I do appreciate them trying to do something a little different with the formula, but, come on, like, honestly, this movie just works best usually when it's just adhering to the formula, which is unfortunate to say, but that's the type of film they set out to do. I will mention, though, that there is one great twist. I'm not going to spoil it. I thought there was going to be a twist coming. I was really fearing it would be the super generic twist in all these spy or cop movies. I'm not going to say what it is, but it wasn't, and it was really awesome and hilarious, and I liked that a lot. Anyway, moving on to the pacing. It's pretty phenomenal. This movie flies by. It's a pretty quick hour and a half. I mean, I know it's a short movie already, but it doesn't lag at all. Even when the plot gets a little weird, it's still entertaining and enjoyable to watch. It bounces around in quality, but it never lost my attention, which I think is really awesome, and that's largely because you're invested in some decent characters that are really well acted, and plus, the script is usually very good. Most of the jokes I think landed were great. They weren't too repetitive, they weren't too childish or anything, but they weren't too adult to make this not a PG-13 movie that you can show most of your kids, and I thought that was really great that they found the balance. Sure, there's the predictable jokes that you'd expect, and there's some that don't really land completely, but for the most part, I thought they were very clever, and there's a few times where they legitimately had me laughing out loud, which is very hard for a film to do, and there was a good probably 5 times that happened, and I love when that happens. There was actually some good physical humor too, which doesn't always happen, but there's just a few scenes that'll actually really stick with you. At least they stuck with me, and I think that's awesome, because this movie isn't just one of those enjoyable watches that you watch once, and you're like, yeah, that was a fun movie. There's some scenes that you'll come back to, not because like great drama or anything, but really because there's some really funny, like, just comedy concepts they put in, and like the way that Dave Bautista is kind of socially awkward in some places is kind of ridiculous and kind of awesome, and I thought that was really cool. Just a bit of a different element, because usually you got just like the tough guy who's like, you know, doesn't have like as much of a heart, but he's like a tough guy. This like added a bit of like that social awkwardness to it that I think is like a great kind of extra level that really elevates the humor. Plus, the 9-year-old girl was playing that part perfectly and really was a great like balancing act between her and Dave Bautista. Sure, this isn't Kumail Nanjiani and Dave going against each other because those are like two comedy giants, and that movie doesn't have the second like great comedic performance exactly, but they're still really good, and the straight performances, like the mom, played off against the comedy ones, work very well, which is really nice to see. Overall, I thought the script was pretty solid, and the tone, it managed really well, which is really impressive for these types of movies. It felt very balanced throughout in managing the drama and comedy. It really definitely had a, more of a comedy focus, but when they switched to more action or drama and kind of developed like the villain plot a little bit, because, you know, it's not a very developed villain plot, or they developed the drama a bit more, I thought it was very believable, and they did a pretty good job. They kept the conflicts going, which I think was nice. So, script's pretty solid, and then that leaves the themes, and yeah, I mean, it's the generic, probably what you'd expect, and that it's like, oh, you gotta always have, you know, a heart and stuff, and, you know, people need human relationships in order to function properly, and, you know, you can't just abandon that in order to be, like, you know, a good person. He has that, like, sad, like, hero backstory of Dave Bautista. And I thought something that was smart about this film is they do make fun of that cliches, and that makes it very, like, irreverent. And I think that's a good strategy when a movie is being kind of predictable and, like, very formulaic. You get irreverent with your script and, like, your themes and concepts and stuff, and that can often work for its benefit. Maybe it's a little bit of, like, a kind of, like, cutting corners strategy, but it works, and I'm perfectly fine with it. I thought it was very clever, and there was some funny, like, run-on gags with it. So, overall, yeah, the theme's a little weak. The script, I really did like. The plot is a little all over the place, and the pacing's really solid. This category, yeah, it's a mixed bag. I'm still giving it a 3 out of 5 for plot, pacing, script, and theme. That leaves my Spy's overall score. So, what's it gonna be? Remember, this isn't an average of the three scores, and the last one definitely has the most weight to it, so that's going to bring it down big time. And my overall score for My Spy is, drumroll please, a 3.25 out of 5. Not bad at all. I enjoyed it greatly. Sure, it's not a great film by any means, and there's a number of problems I recognized with the film while I was watching it, but none that really like impeded upon my enjoyment of it. Sure, there were so many things they could do better that really elevate the film, and that's just something you gotta accept. They really weren't trying to go for great drama or like the villain plot and stuff. This isn't a super dramatic, dark movie or just like a super like plot-dense movie in that regard. It's more of, you know, the older guy is trying to like have like, you know, starts this relationship with this like little girl. I know what I said sounds really creepy, but it's not in the movie, which is a good thing. And basically then he, you know, he develops relationships with a mom, and it's kind of an interesting case study as like, because he's supposed to be surveilling them and stuff. And I thought that was an interesting element. You know where it's gonna go most of the time. Occasionally it'll surprise you, and those surprises are usually pretty great. But yeah, I recommend if you wanna just watch a fun movie in theaters, it's not gonna be an Oscar worthy film, and that's okay. I think you guys should go watch this movie when it comes out in March. It's a fun watch. Don't expect it to be anything amazing, but nevertheless, it's a good time. So thank you for watching this review. I'd love to hear your opinions on My Spy in the comment section down below. Make sure to like and subscribe for more awesome movie videos, reviews, rankings, award season coverage, ton of stuff coming soon. I'll see you guys later. This is Film Frenzy signing off. Goodbye.